Hi all, and happy International Women's Day celebration. International Women's Day is on the 8th of March this year, but as it's a public holiday, we will be celebrating over the next couple of days. So please enjoy this video that's been made by your teachers and your peers to celebrate International Women's Day.
So the theme of 2021's International Women's Day is Choose to Challenge. So for this year, I choose to challenge all those people who are mad passionate AFL supporters to get behind your women's team. I'm a mad Collingwood supporter, so I really follow the AFLW from our captain Kiochi to our really hard hitter Stacey Livingston, Benici, who is all over the gameplay. I challenge those mad footy supporters who know the stats, the histories, all those things about their players to do the same and get behind their female players. The game has just really stepped up and it's a really awesome competition. International Women's Day means that to me. I didn't get to see that when I was in high school, and now young women have something more to aspire to. So keep asking questions, keep challenging, and keep pushing those boundaries. Happy International Women's Day.
Hi everyone, Misty Elvis here. My hero is Queen Elizabeth II. She is super stylish and elegant, and I hope to be just like her when I'm in my 90s. And whether you love her or hate her, she's been on the world stage for about 70 years. Pretty impressive.
There are so many incredible women figures out there today doing amazing things, and I have a few today that I want to share with you. The first is Lupita Nyong'o, who is known for her roles in 12 Years a Slave, Us, and Black Panther, just to name a few, and she is the first Mexican-Kenyan actor to receive an Academy Award. There's Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, who at 31 years old is the youngest woman ever to serve in the United States Congress. There's Ilhan Omar, who is the first Somali-American and naturalized citizen from Africa to serve in the United States Congress, and they're both in Congress today. Isra Hirsi, who's Omar's daughter, she founded the U.S. branch of the Youth Climate Strike, which is a global youth climate change movement. This branch represents communities of color in the United States and has organized multiple strikes throughout the country. And finally, there's Greta Thunberg, who is one of the most well-known young climate activists, who has been fiercely outspoken on the crisis of climate change since the age of 15, and she's won multiple awards for her work. Again, these women have inspired me to live a life full of integrity and greater purpose, and to work hard to make a positive difference in the world.
Hi there, I'm Nathan.
And I'm Winston.
And we're here today to talk to you about International Women's Day. On the 8th of March, we will celebrate International Women's Day, and it is basically a global celebration of the social, economic, cultural, and political achievements of women.
Whether you're a mother or a child, being a woman in today's society can be daunting. It is important to remember what women have contributed to the world and that we should all celebrate their impact on society.
One of my favorite role models is Rosa Parks. She was an American activist and best known for her role in the Montgomery bus boycott. To this day, she has expressed that racial inequality cannot be tolerated and is an inspiration to all Black people today. On a more personal note, my mom will always be my biggest role model. She has always done most things, if not everything, for me. She has gone through so much and still is the strongest person I know.
Next time you happen to talk to your mom, let her know how much you love her. Cherish every moment you spend with her and be grateful for her.
Let's all join together to celebrate International Women's Day.
You've probably heard of Malala Yousafzai. Malala is an extremely inspiring young woman. When the Taliban invaded the Swat Valley in Pakistan, where Malala lived, they made it illegal for girls to receive an education. Along with her father, Malala fought for girls to attend school until one day when Malala was 14. As she travelled home from school on the school bus, the Taliban shot her in the face. Malala is 23 now, and she continues to campaign for girls around the world to receive an education. Malala has written several books, and here's one you can borrow right now. In the words of Malala herself, "We realise the importance of our voices only when we are silenced. Don't let yourself be silenced, girls."
Hi, my name is Kylie, and I will be speaking on behalf of the Year 8's representation for International Women's Day. To me, being a woman means that I'm known for being powerful and facing many challenges and hardships in my life.
Hi everyone, I'm Miss Vass. I'm the Year 7 Coordinator, if you do not know me, here at the Acacia Campus. My inspiration for International Women's Day today is Gemma Sissa. If you look her up, she is an incredible woman who started the School of St. Jude in Tanzania. I got to hear Gemma talk and I got to read her book when I was 16, and it really inspired me about this idea of empowerment. So Gemma explores the idea that we volunteer, and it's fantastic that we volunteer. However, we might be making a change in someone's life for one day or 2 days and not ongoing. So the idea of empowering people rather than just helping them little bit by little bit. And she began this massive school in St. Jude in Tanzania in Africa that is for the disadvantaged students that don't have access to education. And she employed local staff and upskilled them, and now the school is really self-sustainable in its own right, which is fantastic.
What does being a woman mean to you? Being a woman means being able to be powerful, confident and assertive, yet kind, caring, sensitive and supporting. We strive for our goals even in the face of criticism, meaning we don't give up as soon as something hurtful comes towards us.
This International Women's Day, I would like to talk about someone that inspired me. When I was 17 years old, I walked into my local library, resume in hand, and asked to speak to the manager. I had expected to speak to the branch manager, but instead it was the operations manager that came out to meet me. The operations manager oversaw the library management of 13 branches. This was a woman by the name of Tara, and she completely altered the trajectory of my life. We are inspired by people who are passionate about something, and Tara was passionate about libraries. She wanted them to be all that they can be, so much more than just a place where you put books. She wanted them to be a vibrant community space for everyone. She was kind and professional, but very firm in her beliefs, happy to question process and not satisfied with doing things just because that was how they had always been done. Her passion for libraries was contagious, and because of the key values she instilled with me, I'm still here loving life in a library 18 years later. To this day, I still find myself standing in my library, looking around and asking, what would Tara do?
You shouldn't shame a woman for something that a man does on a regular basis.
Fetishization isn't acceptable. Trans women are 10 times more likely to get assaulted.
Happy International Women's Day to all my fellow women and men out there. I'm proud of the strides and efforts we've made to get where we are today, but there's always more we can do to bridge the gap and promote gender equality. So make sure you have your voice heard, and together we can create a world where everyone is treated with respect and are treated as equals. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I just wanted to talk to you about inspirational women, and somebody that I find hugely inspiring is a lady called Ada Lovelace. Now, she was born in 1815, and she was the first computer scientist. Now, this was in a time before computers were even invented and before electricity was even around. She designed an algorithm that would run on a mechanical computer, basically a big calculator, a counting machine made of cogs and wheels, made of metal and wood. She worked with a man called Charles Babbage, who designed the Babbage counting machine. Now, this again was 100 years before the first computers were really designed. First digital computers were designed in the 1940s. And I think it's really important to reflect on the fact that often behind the person who's credited with a discovery, often unfortunately a male, there's often a very strong female who's had to battle the odds. And we still see today that in computer sciences and in engineering and in science, women are massively underrepresented as a proportion of the population.
A woman that inspires me would be the songwriter her. She produces music that educates common life struggles that people in the world often experience. She also empowers women with her music that she produces, and she also talks about the Black community that should be more aware of.
I know it sounds like a massive cliche, but a female who has had a profound effect on all our lives is Marie Curie. So she was a physicist and chemist who was highly active around 100 years ago now. But the work that she did, the research that she did into radioactivity actually lives on today. So when we think about radioactivity, we can look at things like industry and power generation, agriculture and food we use it, as well as carbon dating techniques. But the reason why I find her so inspirational is because of the effect that she had on another female hero of mine, who's my mother. So my mum was a breast cancer survivor, and she actually treated her breast cancer with radiotherapy. So she was able to survive because of the work that was done 100 years prior by Marie Curie. So big thanks to Marie there.
I am woman. I am me. This is me. I am woman.